Hi, I'm Nathan, and in this video, we're going to talk about custom dimensions and custom metrics on Google Analytics. Every Google Analytics report has attributes and quantitative measurements. Some of the attributes in Google Analytics, like gender, top pages, customer lifetime value, and so forth, are not tracked by default. So you can create customized dimensions and metrics to track them. Customized dimensions track attributes of data like weather, gender, location, timestamp, and so on, whereas custom metric tracks quantitative measurements like the number of page views or time left on page. Customized dimensions cushion metrics in context. So every metric includes at least one dimension. For example, the number of users from a country. Here, the number of users is a metric by which the country of the user is a dimension that offers us context. Now, can you identify the metric and dimension in the statement shown on the screen? Do you know why this feature offered by Google Analytics is ideal? First, it saves you from getting buried under a plethora of automatically generated reports that may not be relevant to your business goals by enabling you to track only that is relevant to your business. Second, this is gold for any business looking to scale up as their efforts are supplemented by exploring custom attributes and gaining actionable insights on metrics that address their specific needs. Third, real-time insights from custom dimensions help in data augmentation. This adds depth to the data of user activity on any page of your website. To get started, venture into the admin tab in your Google Analytics account and click on the property column. Select custom dimensions and you will set up the customized metric and dimensions around them and then modify your tracking code. To set up, first define configuration values. Some of them are first, the name. This is a label for the custom metric or dimension. The second is scope, and this defines the extent of data that Google Analytics will gather. There are four scope levels that are allowed. The first is a hit, which gathers data in page views and clicks. One hit represents a single activity, like a click or a page view. The second is a session, which is an aggregate of hits by a user. The third is a user, which is an aggregation of all sessions and hits by a single user ID. And the fourth is a product, which gathers product-related data for e-commerce websites. The third configuration value is type, which is only needed while adding a customized metric. This defines the formatting type of the metric. And last is the maximum or minimum values, which defines the range within which we want data values for analysis. After saving your configured values, you will receive an index number. This index number is for your records only to identify specific sets of dimensions and metrics that you will create each time. Your customized attributes are all set up now. To start receiving data, modify your tracking code by copying the gtag.js code snippet from the platform. Let's understand the use of custom dimensions and metrics with a real-time example. Meet my Uncle John, the owner of an e-commerce store who plans to expand his business in a new region. He wants to analyze user behavior located in Texas for some specific hours in the morning. Some of the custom definitions that can benefit John are user location, timestamp that shows the exact time of the interaction, the weather conditions, page views, and the gender of signed in users. By setting up these custom dimensions, he can easily retrieve the required data and perform his analysis. The insights from this analysis will set him up for future success. Knowing this, you must be eager to learn in depth about your customers' actions and behavior on your site. Why don't you go ahead and get started? I hope that helps answer some of the questions you may have around custom dimensions within the Google Analytics environment. Feel free to share some of your fantastic use cases for the custom definitions in the comments below.
Data Science Dojo. Data science for everyone.